Welcome back to the Collector Zone. I'm Jeff Dickinson, and we got another childhood video game I'm looking forward to opening here. The search has continued, and I wasn't 100% if I was going to do this, but after playing a few games from my childhood, I totally had to go for it. So, I found this on a nice little auction. Let's see, pull it out here. It's snug in there, man. Okay, here we go. I like it when it's packaged really nicely. So yeah, I picked this up on the auction. And the cool part is, check this out. This is what I dig about finding these old school carts. So, this is, of course, you know, the Jedi Arena. This is the one that's a PAL game that, as a kid, I had a tough time with. And I was almost not going to buy it. But check this out. This is what changed my mind. It's from Game World. And so I'll need to look it up and see if they're in business. But this is a rental cart. And I didn't know that they did that back for the 2600s. This was like in the 80s. So, you know, I'm not 100% if they ran these, but apparently this one did. So what I want to do here, I got to clean this bad boy. Let's go ahead and check out the commercial for Star Wars Jedi Arena.
You are entering a battlefield of the future. The Star Wars Jedi Arena.
Becoming a Jedi Master takes practice. Using your lightsaber, try to penetrate your opponent's defenses. But watch out, the Whirling Seeker can attack on its own. So follow your instincts. Ah, now you're ready to take on any challenger who dares to oppose you.
Play the Jedi Arena home video game. Alone or head-to-head, the challenge awaits you. From Parker Brothers, the ones to beat.
Man, I dig those old school commercials. Now, the cart was in pretty decent condition for being a rental. Gotta love that John Williams music. What I wanted to do here was make sure it was clean. And it didn't have much dirt on the actual cart itself on the inside. The outside, I just kind of cleaned up a little bit with alcohol. I did look it up, and the company, Game World, is no longer in business, but they were located in Las Vegas based upon information on the cart. I found some pictures. Check this out, man. Pretty cool, right? I mean, to see where it came from, that's really badass. Now, like I mentioned before, this was an auction. I've paid more for shipping than I did for the cart. Cart was like $5 and change, and the shipping was like $6. In my personal opinion, if you guys want to just get the game itself, the cart by itself, I personally wouldn't pay more than about $10-$15. I was comfortable in the area. I felt that was a fair price for the game, because you have to remember, there's a lot of these games out there. They didn't just make a few of them, so trust me. These are not as valuable as people are thinking they are. Now, if you wanted to get the complete box set, and like I said, I wasn't really looking for this game. It just kind of was an accident. If you're looking for the whole box set, as I was looking through other complete box games for Star Wars, this one, you know, it's all over the place. I personally wouldn't pay past $30, maybe $40, depending upon condition, because of the fact that a lot of people didn't really keep the box and manual, and I was one of those kids. So, yeah, if you get a complete box, I would say $30-$40 is fair. Now, keep in mind, if you're looking for a instruction booklet with the game itself, that's kind of all over the place. So, use your discretion. Closer to the single cart price with the manual, the better I feel comfortable with. I may pay an extra $5. If it's worth it to me to have that manual. But never fear, man. Just like every one of these videos I've been putting out on the channel, there's a link below to the manual. All right, so let's talk about the game. It's a killer paddle game. You know my feelings on these paddle games. All right, so there's going to be one-player, two-player games. There's a total of 8 games, half for one, half for two players, and it's all about speed. So right there it says player one, slow. You got two players, so I believe player one is the blue dude. There's medium, so it's a little bit challenging there. And there's two player. And then there's fast, one and two. And this is invisible, so you don't know where that little orb is. Now, for those who don't know, was this game based upon Star Wars? Well, in the original film, Luke is training with Obi-Wan Kenobi. Remember that scene?
Remember, a Jedi can feel the Force flowing through him.
You mean it controls your actions?
Partially, but it also obeys your commands.
Alright, so let's go ahead and I want to do medium. Now, I know you're pushing your fire, so you're pushing your fire button and it shoots at this other dude. So, your goal here is to, so your goal is to clear out the little things, the protecting things, the force shield, I guess you call it, and it gets a little nuts, man, and I just, I just died, man. So the dude gets a point. So now I'm on top. So they're like going, "Hey man, let's try a different angle. Maybe it'll help you." I don't know, but that's pretty much, you know, the way this is. And as a kid, I was like going, "Okay, there's got to be more. There's got to be a strategy to it." But for the life of me, I just couldn't figure it out. Uh-oh, this dude's getting nuts, man. He's getting nuts. Crapola. I got to take that left, the right-hand side there. I'm trying to figure out how you... Yeah, I died again. I was trying to figure out how you get aim, like, this thing up here to shoot that dude. And I was aiming by, you know, moving this. And that's just moving the lightsaber, man. So I'm not 100%. So, yeah, I'm going to have to look into this a little bit more, guys. That's just, you know. Here, let me go to a different game here. Let's go fast. And this is what I used to do as a kid, man. I was like, well, screw it. I'm going in. My brother, you won't survive. I'm using the force. Yeah, man. I mean, this is one that I remember. I was trying to think back. Empire Strikes Back came out first. Let me grab that here. So Empire Strikes Back came out first. This was 82. And then Return of the Jedi, the Death Star. Let's see here. Yeah, Death Star Battle. This came out in 83. And then this game is 83 too. I don't know how the hell I'm still alive if I haven't been doing nothing. Oh, man. And of course, you know, we gotta just check out the invisible. Yeah, see, you just can't see him.
With the blast shield down, I can't even see. How am I supposed to fight?
Your eyes can deceive you. Don't trust them.
Ah.
stretch out with your feelings. You see? You can do it.
Yeah, man. I guess that's what it looks like with the blast shields down. Well, guys, I appreciate the hang time. I just want to share some of these childhood video games I'm enjoying as a kid. I had joy as a kid that I'm playing again as an adult. And I really dig them, man. I mean, it's a really cool game. As far as how cool this is, I gotta remember, I was a kid who was impatient, man. I was fighting AT-AT walkers. I was blowing up Death Stars. The next thing I know, for the new game, I was, yes, I want a lightsaber. And then it was like this guy just sitting down here, like a, what do you call it? You remember those Fisher-Price toys? Kind of reminds me of one of those. Anywho. Anywho? Well, the hell is that coming from? Anyway, guys, I appreciate you. Until next time, my fellow gamers, game on. I'm, gonna be doing pretty good with the blast shield on. Laters.